If I don't get 10 reps, I don't go to floor. In a week.
Ah. Oh, shit.
So I just got back from work. I had to go in and take care of some stuff for deployment coming up. It's 3:20 right now. I'm gonna eat this meal and then I'm gonna wait for a couple hours and then I'm going to eat another meal before going and training back today with Tim. Welcome to video number 2. My second YouTube video. We'll see how this one goes compared to the last one. But I felt like the last one was pretty good. Anyways, there was something about 5:30 p.m. that makes this old man tired as hell. I don't know what it is. I don't know if you guys are similar. 5:30 comes around, 5 o'clock comes around, 4:30 comes around. It, like, anytime after like 3 p.m. comes around, and I'm so tired. I have like no energy. But irregardless, we're gonna hit back day today with Tim. So I'm gonna make my pre-workout. I already ate my pre-workout meal, which was 2 sourdough English muffins with honey on them. Since I don't have jelly, I normally eat jelly with it. And then one of those triple zero Oikos Greek yogurt things with 20 grams of protein. That was my pre-workout meal for today. That's my pre-workout meal pretty much every day. Except sometimes I have 2 of those Oikos things, depending on how much I've eaten earlier in the day. Short people problems. My pre-workout lately has been this Rise Godzilla pre-workout. It's actually really good. I've really enjoyed it lately. I have tried so many different types of pre-workouts and this one is actually like bomb.com. Also, this is an oxygen to nitric oxide booster, I believe. But my buddy Carter Cook back at DLI in Monterey introduced me to this thing. And I think it helps give me pretty good pumps. So I saw it in the vitamin shop a couple weeks ago, decided I would buy it again and give it a shot, and it's been awesome. I've actually liked that. And then creatine. I actually haven't taken creatine in like years. But one of my friends is taking creatine and she's strong as fuck. She looks awesome, and she just takes it every day with her protein. At the end of the day, I had been doing it with my pre-workout, but then seeing her do it, I was like, am I not taking creatine? A lot of people say that creatine is good. So why not get some cellular hydration and amplified recovery? That's my pre-workout. Shake this up real nice. And I like to drink this on the way to the gym. I don't drink it all at once. I like to sip on it on the way to the gym because I have about a 25-minute drive. I'm gonna get everything packed up, ready to go, and head to the gym. Right now? I always feel like I have to like jump out of the chair, you know? From doing that.
I've been swiveling and I swivel around out of it. That's what that smell is.
My knees, yeah.
They smell sour.
They smell so bad. I should probably wash them.
Yeah.
I've had them for like 2 years. I've never washed them.
Health and comfort. I should probably wash those. Yeah. My son be kicking my block out of the way like he don't like that shit. Leave my block alone. Let's go.
Might need a warm up a little more.
Yeah, nice and slow.
Woo! Nature boy. That's dark. A little brighter. Boom. Hit leg day with Timotheus. Zoom in. We started out with hamstring curls. Now we're hitting some squats. We're about to hit 315 for up to 10 reps. Tim's gonna hit 315 for 10 for the first time in his life. And then we're gonna go up from there probably to 345. See what we can do. I've done this before. I've done three sets of 10 reps.
Monster.
That was during prep too.
That's monster.
So, this ain't shit. If I don't get 10 reps, I don't go to floor. In a week. I'm just kidding.
He said it.
I already bought the tickets.
Everybody wanna be a bodybuilder.
Alright. 2 3 Get up. 4 5 Breathe. Big breath. Stay tight at the bottom. Up. 6 More work. More work. 7 3 on you. Eight.
I got it.
All right. I'm staying away. Nine. Last one. Best one. Ten. Ball game. Ball game, motherfucker.
Oh. Ow. Those are probably terrible reps, but we did it. Chris Bumstead, I'll see you in 2 weeks. Ow. Oh, shit. Okay, so we got done with squats. I outlifted Tim by a mile. No, I'm just kidding. I got more reps on 315 than he did, but you got more reps on the back off 225 than I did. Irregardless, we're hitting hip thrust and adductor superset. Because we gotta get those big juicy peaches so we don't look flat like a pancake on the stage. So we're hitting hip thrust, we're going not heavy, because I have a terrible amount of muscle connection with my glutes. So I'm going light and just trying to squeeze super hard. Shout out to Lexi, teaching me how to do wide instead of going narrow like I normally do on these. And then we're doing the adductors to superset to get the big beefy inner thighs. Ow! My back hurts. Gentlemen, don't be afraid to hit hip thrust. Show off how much you can hip thrust. You know what I'm saying? Ah. Ah. It's all squishy. My nuts, dude. I don't know how to not do that. If you guys have advice for how to not make my nuts squish on the adductors, that would be great. Okay, let's move on.
Ancho, I need to borrow some sweats.
Okay. Second to last thing we're doing is stationary Smith machine squats. Single leg Smith. Wait. No, stationary Smith machine. And this is the next thing we're doing. We got the front leg elevated, and whatever foot is forward, we're sinking into that hip. So we're gonna twist a little bit, sink into that hip, so that way we're hitting the glutes as well. That's like the outer quads. Kind of the quads. Actually, I'm doing the inner quads too. But we're supersetting this with the line hamstring curl, which is what I posted last leg day, so I'm not gonna have footage of that. But we're supersetting this with line hamstring curl. We're getting like 10 to 12 reps on this, but they're really slow, controlled, and we're just focusing on hitting the glutes, hitting the quads, and getting like all of the blood that we have left in our body into our legs and our ass cheeks. So this is how it's done. Gotta give credit where credit's due. John Meadows. I got this from John Meadows. So, RIP, but that's what I got. Oh, I'm on the right one.
last thing that we're doing, last superset, is leg extensions and calf raises. For the leg extensions, you'll notice that when I come up, I'm not throwing it up so hard that I do a little bounce at the end. I'm just bringing it up and contracting my knees, or contracting my quads, so that all the tension stays in the muscle, and it doesn't, it's not just momentum or anything like that, but it's actually me just keeping all the weight on the quads. And then, nothing special about these, just calf raises. But do calf raises. I gotta grow my calves. I'm looking a little soft, yeah? So, except I do get a lot of compliments on my calves. But anyways. Think about this, just a little tip. When you're doing calves, instead of thinking about pressing your toes down, think about bringing your heels up. You know what I mean? So instead of pressing down in your toes, think about bringing your heel up, and you're gonna feel, you'll feel a much deeper contraction in the calves. May even get a cramp. May even see some calf growth. May turn them into cows. Anyways, that's it, we're done. Thanks for hanging out on legs, let's do some posing. There we go.
This guy's scared. This guy's scared. How you said it too? This guy's scared.
No, you go right here.
Why?
Oh, I'm sorry. Ah, you're the overall. I got second place. Alright. Post leg day posing. Post leg. Where's your microphone?
Is that all? I can't hook you.
Okay. Alright. Zena. Hi, Zena.